In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who raised up Saint Mark, your evangelist, and endowed him with the grace to preach the gospel, grant, we pray, that we may so profit from his teaching as to follow faithfully in the footsteps of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, clothe yourselves with humility in your dealings with one another. For God opposes the proud, but bestows favor on the humble. So humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your worries upon him, because he cares for you. Be sober and vigilant. Your opponent, the devil, is prowling around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in faith, knowing that your brothers and sisters throughout the world undergo the same feelings or sufferings. The God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory through Christ Jesus, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you after you have suffered a little. To him be dominion forever. Amen. I write you this briefly through Silvanus, whom I consider a faithful brother, exhorting you and testifying that this is the true grace of God. Remain firm in it. The chosen one at Babylon sends you greetings, as does Mark, my son. Greet one another with loving kiss. Peace to all of you who are in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. The favors of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations, my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, my kindness is established forever. In heaven, you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The heavens proclaim your wonders, O Lord, and your faithfulness in the assembly of the holy ones. For who in the skies can rank with the Lord? Who is like the Lord among the sons of God?
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Blessed the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name, they rejoice all the day, and through your justice, they are exalted.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. Please all stand.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus appeared to the 11 and said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover." Then the Lord Jesus, after he spoke to them, was taken up into heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God. But they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Today is the feast day of Saint Mark, the Evangelist. Saint Mark, the Evangelist, is the companion of Saint Peter. He also the secretary of Saint Peter and translator. Kaya po, Saint Mark and Saint Peter, they are partners, especially in proclaiming the gospel. At napakaganda pong makita rin, may commonalities po yung dalawa. Ano po ibig sabihin, sila pong dalawa ay santo. Ibig sabihin, ito pong hamon sa atin Jesus na ipahayag ang mabuting balita sa buong mundo, sila po mismo ang nagsabuhay sa kanilang buhay. At isa pa pong makikita sa kanilang buhay, hindi lang sila basta santo, kundi sila ay martyrs, silang dalawa. Ang sabi po, ang mga martyrs, yung kanila pong buhay mismo ang inalay sa pananampalataya. At yung kanilang pananampalataya na yun, yung malalim, proceeds from their authentic love for Jesus. Kaya ibig sabihin po, inalay nila yung kanilang buhay alang-alang sa pananampalataya, alang-alang sa pag-ibig ng Diyos. Ibig sabihin po, yung kanila pong buhay is the living testimony na kung saan sila mismo sa kanilang buhay, isinabuhay nila itong mabuting balita. Kaya mga kapatid, ito pong si Saint Mark as a Saint Peter ay talaga magpartner. In today's gospel, sinasabi dito yung hamon sa atin that Jesus urges us to proclaim the gospel to the whole world. Paano po natin ito maipoproclaim? Dahil po sa kanila pinakitang halimbawa na sa kanila pong mismong buhay nahayag ang mabuting balita. Ibig sabihin, ang mabuting balita po ay may kapartner din. Ano pong kapartner ng mabuting balita? Hindi po yung ating mga gawa. Ang mabuting balita po ay inahayag sa ating magagandang gawa. Kaya mga kapatid, hindi lang po ito pong mabuting balita ay may kapartner ding isa. Ano pa po? Yung first reading. Magagawa po natin yung hamon ni Jesus na ipahayag ang mabuting balita sa buong mundo, para po ang lahat ay sumampalataya sa Kanya. Paano po ay kailangan po sa ating sarili ito mahayag. Kaya nga po yung first reading tumutukoy na clothe yourself with humility in dealing with one another. In dealing with one another, ibig sabihin, sa ating pong pakikisalamuha sa ating kapwa, yun po yung avenue na kung saan doon po ipapahayag ang mabuting balita. Sa at ang apoteng mabuting balita, ito po ay makikita na ating sinasabuhay sa ating pakikasalamuha sa kapwa. Kapag po ang pakikasalamuha natin sa ating kapwa ay hindi maayos, hindi maganda, tayo ay masyadong mapagmataas, tayo ay may kayabangan taglay sa ating sarili, tayo ang magaling, ito pa'y taliwas sa mabuting balita. Kaya po sabi dito, taliwas yun. Sa hindi yun ang hindi natin magagampanan yung hamon ni Jesus na ipahayag nito kung ating sarili ay nababalot ng ganito. Kaya sabi ng Panginoon, instead na magagawa ninyo maipahayag ang mabuting balita, yung sinabi sa yung sa sulat ni St. Peter na clothe yourself with humility. May kababaan loob. Kapag tayo may kababaan loob, may papahayag natin ng maayos ang mabuting balita sa ating pagkikapagkapwa. Na kapag ang pagkikapagkapwa natin ay mayroong pag-ibig, may pagkalinga, may pagmamahal, yun po yun. Yun po yung diwa ng ating mabuting balita. At yun po ang nagpapatunay ng inyong buhay ay buhay ang mensahe ng mabuting balita. Mahirap po itong gawin, itong challenge na ito, ng unang-una sapagkat ay ang mabuting balita ay kailangan unang-unang mayahayag sa ating sarili at sa ating pamilya. Mahirap po yun in reality. Pero makakayanan po natin sapagkat pero tayong kapartner. Sino po? Si Jesus. Sabi niya po dito, the very essence nitong message, yung gospel na ito, na tayo ay sa pagpapahayag ng mabuting balita, kasama natin siya. Kaya wala tayong dapat ikatakot at ipangamba kahit merong appearance of trials and difficulties and barriers sa pagsasabuhin na ito sapagkat siya ay kasama natin at siya po mismo ang nagbibigay ng pagpapala at grasya. Tingnan po dito sa ating mabuting balita na kung bakit nakakagawa ng himala ang mga apostol sapagkat kaagapay nila ang ating Panginoon. Mga kapatid, gawin po nating partner ang ating Panginoon sa ating sarili, sa ating buhay, upang sa ating pamumuhay, kahit ito ay in the ordinary, as in our ordinary life, nasasabuhin natin ipapahayag ating mabuting balita sa ating in our dealings with one another. Kaya po mga kapatid, sa pagpatuloy po ng ating banal na misa, tamang-tama atin pong matatanggap ang ating Panginoong Hesus. Na kung saan kapag ito natanggap natin at pinagsikapan natin tanggapin ang ating Panginoong Hesus, si Hesus po mismo ay ating mananahan sa ating kalooban sa ating pagtanggap sa Holy Communion. Kaya po, ay kapag natanggap natin siya, may kapartner na tayo sapagkat siya'y kasama na sama natin sa ating buhay. Kaya mga kapatid, wala po dapat tayo ikapangamba. Sa halip, tayo po'y magtiwala sa Panginoon, magsumikap na isa buhay ang mabuting balita upang ito'y may pahayag na may katapangan at may pakumbabaan. Katulad po ni San Marcos, kaya po ang imahin ni San Marcos ay mayang leon at na may pakpak. Siya po ay naglalakbay at mayroon tapang na ipahayag ang mabuting balita. Kaya po, igayon din, magagawa natin yun sa tulong ni San Marcos. Magagawa natin itong hamon ni Jesus na ipalaganap ito. Kaya po ay tayo po ay unang-una ay mahalin natin ang ating Panginoong Jesus para maging buhay siya sa ating buhay. At upang sa ating buhay, buhay na buhay ang mensahe ng mabuting balita.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let us all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
As we venerate the glory of Saint Mark, we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of praise and humbly beseech you that your church may always persevere in the preaching of the gospel through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Mark, and with all the saints we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gilbert, our Bishop, the Order of Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Please all stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Those who cannot kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the parish and national shrine of St. Padre Pio, and for the needs and welfare of the sick and retired priest of the Archdiocese of Lipa. Thank you for your offering. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that what we have received from your holy altar may sanctify us and make us strong in the faith of the gospel which Saint Mark proclaimed, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for intercession to Saint Padre Pio. All together, Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage, with you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that we concede. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the most holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit, and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcements. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa Pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ng inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, sabag na nais nating palawakin ng dokumentasyon at datos ng mga pilgrims and devotees na bumibisita sa Pambansang Dambana, kami po ay nag-aanyaya sa inyong lahat na makilahok sa ginagawang pagkalakap ng impormasyon na makakatulong sa pagpapaunlad ng ating turismong pangsimbahan. Makikisuyo po kami na paki-scan ang QR code na inyong makikita sa paligid ng simbahan at pakikumpleto ng mga impormasyong kinakailangan. Makakaasa po kayo sa aming pag-iingat ng private information na inyong ibabahagi bilang pagsunod sa batas ng Data Privacy Act of 2012. Ang inyong pakikiisa ay malaking tulong at susi sa tagumpay ng proyektong ito. Ikatlo, iwan ang pananalangin sa labas ng ating simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas na religious articles.
O Lord God, you are the source of all blessings and grace. Pour out your blessing on these instruments of prayer, rosaries, images, prayers, roses that remind us of your goodness, holiness, and love to us, so that all who came and pray through them may receive your mercy and grace. Through them, help the faithful imitate the holiness and teaching of the Lord and the saints forever.
Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Heaven rejoice.